Welcome everybody to week 3 Sunday Night Griffleball matchup between the GasHouse Gorillas and the Nighttime Ninjas. Please players, as I call your names for the lineup, stand on your respective foul lines and we'll get going. So for the GasHouse Gorillas, leading off, Ryan Gallagher. Batting second, Jeremy Radishak. Batting third and starting pitching tonight, Jim Tucker. And batting fourth, John Reyna. And for the home team, we got old school Griffleball here, the Nighttime Ninjas. Batting first, Sammy Kruchek. And batting second, and starting pitchers for the first game today, Mike Kubaki Jr. Please, if everyone will remove your hats and face the flag for our national anthem.
Hey, new Walker.
Hey, we are back here for Sunday Night Griffleball week 3 matchup between the GasHouse Gorillas and Nighttime Ninjas. And I'm joined by our rookie in the booth, first time ever coming to Griffleball, my blood, Kyle Gagliardi.
What is going on, everyone? Griffleball Nation. Kyle Gagliardi here, joining my cousin on the broadcast tonight.
How's it going? Oh, well, here's your first action, so what did you see in today's game?
Not a lot of offense.
No, not at all.
I mean, the wind didn't really help much today. The conditions were not ideal for hitting, I guess you could say.
Yeah, definitely this year so far, no offense. It could be the weather, but I think we're about ready to go. Mike Kubaki Jr. is going to be on the mound for the Nighttime Ninjas.
Beautiful beard, I might have.
Great. 0-1 so far, 3 innings pitched, 0 ERA, 0 hits allowed. He's got a loss.
Speaking of the beard, he looks like he can mop the floor with
it. He probably could. And we got Gallagher up. First pitch, strike one. Gallagher hitting 571, 0 home runs, 1 RBI so far this year.
For the 5-time champion.
Yes. We all know it. I think I've said it a few hundred times. Hits the left side. Kruchak's going to be all over it. First out of the inning.
Start for Kubaki.
Up next here is Jeremy Radishak, reigning MVP. Rad so far this year. 333.
That's up for the GasHouse Gorillas. Number 47, Jeremy Radishak.
And 3 RBIs.
Yeah, he's rolling with the White Sox beginning of the night. It is a little cold, like we said. About 43 degrees.
He made some motion up there. Not sure what's going on. Oh, okay.
He is enjoying Subway. PA announcer.
PA announcer. What would you get over there, PA?
It's like chicken.
We'll want another count. Chicken something.
Chicken Bacon Ranch. That is a power move if you're going to Subway.
Tips it. 1-1 the count.
I'm actually shaking.
Is it that cold?
For me, it is.
I think we're used to. You should have been here last week when it was raining on everybody. It was pretty cold.
No, it was a good reason to miss last week.
2-1, a little bit low.
No, I think WWE Payback was on. That's
Payback.
Yeah, that's why I didn't attend.
We do have a few WWE fans in this league. Next pitch, 3-1 to count, a little bit high.
Yeah, you will hear that with the walk-up songs on some of these.
Not anyone not in here. These. Yeah, earlier we heard some.
Stock and driver, yes.
Rat fouls it off, count now 3-2.
Battle, baby.
Obviously, crew check out there playing in right center. Grant likes to pull it, so he should probably play a little bit more to the right.
Rubbing his hands together. You got to stay warm.
Must be
out
cool.
There.
Full count here. 4-2. Like, so far, no hits allowed, so we'll see if he can keep
it
that trend.
It is very early.
It is very early. One out so far.
I'm still shaking.
Right back to the pitcher, follows it, and stays with it on the mound for the second out. So good concentration there for Mikey on the mound. And we're going to the bottom of the first. No score. And this Sunday Night Griffleball broadcast is brought to you by Ballistics. Download their interactive sports app or check out their website at ballisticsports.com. Go Ballistic or go home. And we're back here from the bottom of the first inning on the mound for the GasHouse Gorillas. Cy Young Award winner, Jim Tucker. Tucker, last year. This year, 1-0 so far, 3 innings pitched, 1 hit allowed, 5 strikeouts, no walks, 0 ERA. And Krucek is going to lead off for the Nighttime Ninjas. First action so far in this early campaign.
We know for the Nighttime Ninjas, the fielder, number 13, Sammy Krucek.
Considered one of the best hitters, won the Silver Slugger Award last year, so we have the Silver Slugger going against the Cy Young.
That's what you want to tune in for right here.
And then, so they hit 548, 20 home runs, 56 RBIs last season.
Number 13, Manny Machado.
Ooh, first pitch.
That is gas.
Yes, it was. 0-1.
Gas from the Gas House Gorilla himself.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we're very punny here.
0-1. Low, 1-1 the count. Come on, baby. Gallagher playing out left center, looking for the pull. Of course, if Krucek gets a hold of it, it's going to fly. 1-1 the count. Next pitch. Low, 2-1.
This weather, it might be a little difficult to try it.
With the early games, we didn't see much offense. At all.
None. Whatsoever.
There's a strike right there. Swings right through it. 1-2.
The runs we saw in the earlier games were from walks.
Pretty much. Well, except for the triple. That was about it.
Majority of them.
Next pitch. Fouls it off.
Battling up there.
Count remains the same.
Those watching, 5 balls is a walk.
Yes.
Right. Some people were confused last week. I was watching.
There's a ball right there.
Yeah, so 5 balls is a walk.
2-2.
Yes. 2 hit by pitchers is also a base.
Yep. Also get a base on balls for that one. Fights it off, count remains the same.
I had a lot of people asking last week, so should we throw it out there?
Tuck ready on the mound. Here comes a pitch. And gets him with a nice little off-speed pitch for the first out of the inning. So one out going up. Up next for the Nighttime Ninjas, Mike Kubacki Jr. waiting for his walk-up music. Looks like the manager of the Gas House Gorillas, the honest team, is helping him with this one.
Pitcher number 10, Michael Kubacki.
First pitch for Tucker. Strike one. 0-1 on the count.
That's a very tough pitch to hit right there.
Yeah, the strike zone's a lot lower than it was last
Mike
year.
Mike Kubacki rocking the World Series Championship Chicago Cubs winter hat.
No surprise. 1-1. That ball came back and hit me. Not feel good. Felt that one. Mikey on the right. Ear.
You got enough cushion for the pusher.
Oh, of course. Good call. Hitting 400 right now.
You're absolutely right, Boom.
There's a strike right there. Swings through it. Mikey hitting 400. 0 home runs. 1 RBI on the year. Count out 1-2.
To be honest with you, I'm actually surprised with his performance so far this year.
400? Why would you say that? There's strike 3 for the second out, so
that's why.
2 up, 2 down, and we're going to go back here right on top of the second. Jim Tucker leading off in the Gas House Gorillas. Tucker so far this season, leading the league in average 667, 4 for 6, 0 home runs, 0 RBIs, no walks, no strikeouts. Getting on base, getting hit.
He's
definitely jamming out the original walk-up. They're almost ready to go here to start the top of the second.
Leading off for the Gas House Gorillas, pitcher number 34, Jim
Tucker. Probably just the longest walk-up of the day so far.
Huh?
Longest walk-up of the day. First pitch from Mike. Tucker hey, baby. To the left. Will it stay in? No, it's going to go foul. 0-1 the count.
Couldn't be last
week. 0-1 the count. Very close right there. Almost got it over the tree. Next pitch. Chops on it. It looks like it's going to stay fair for the first out of the inning. So 3 ground outs so far from the Gas House Gorillas. Not much solid contact. Here's John Reyna making his first appearance for the Gas House Gorillas.
A t-shirt and shorts here in 43 degree
water. Extra hitter number 13, John Reyna.
last year, Rana. With the Stallion Airs, hit 250 with 3 home runs and 10 RBIs.
That was last year, you're saying?
Yes, this is last year. First pitch was a ball. It's way in front of it, now 1-1.
Kibaki seems to be mixing up speeds a lot too early.
1-1 count. I think he's going to have to do that to beat GasHouse.
I'm going to keep them honest.
Popped him up. Can anyone, can Mikey get there? He's under it, and it's the second out. So another quick 1-2 inning. We're going to go to the bottom of the second. No score. And this year's Home Run Derby in 2017 GBL All-Star Game will be sponsored by and played on location at Bridges Scoreboard. Ready to go here for the bottom of the second. Getting pumped up here.
Number 13 fielder, Sammy Kruchek.
Leading off here, Sammy struck out his first at bat against Jim.
Something like going to Derulo to danger zone.
First pitch, high fastball.
That sound heard was the bowl, not the strike.
So count out 1-0 here. Gallagher playing in left center. Him with a nice little off-speed pitch there. 1-1 the count. Swing and miss. Nice pitch from Tucker. Try to get him again. Didn't take it. 2-1. How would you feel about facing Jim Tucker?
I would.
There's a lot of hitters said that too. 3-1. Good eye from Kruchek.
I don't swing the bat that often anymore. You know, I'm retired.
Huh. No free agency? I thought you were talking about playing.
I mean,
no?
Yes.
4-1.
I'm open to talks.
With who?
Anyone.
Have you heard it first? Color commentator looking to play. And no takers.
Unless I'm on the move.
And there's a strike, 4-2.
Coming in at about 90-something miles per hour.
I think we clocked it last year. I think it was about 97.
That's why. That's why I just said.
97. Pitch from Tuck. Back in the chase, but that's going to be a leadoff walk for Sammy Kruchek. Up next, on the 1-2 combo, here's Mikey Kubaki Jr.
Pitcher number 10, Mike Kubaki.
Yeah, we can guess there's multiple podcasts. First pitch to him.
Ooh.
Jams him a little bit, swings, and strike one. I like the tape on the bat. It's all taped.
It's going all black with blue and white at the grip.
Buys it off. It's a little bit late.
All black, just like he likes in the window.
Oh, 0-2. I don't know about that one.
What happened?
0-2 the count.
Don't worry about it. I'm not loud enough.
Tries to get him with the slider there. He hits it, makes contact, and ground out to Tucker for out number one. Up next here is
fielder number 13,
Sammy Kruchek.
Sammy going to try to advance himself on the base path here.
It'd be interesting. First pitch, fastball.
Only a wiffle ball can you see that. You
only Griffleball.
Yes, Griffleball.
0-1. Next pitch from Tucker. 0-2. Quick pace to this game. Kind of like last week's first game between the dudes and Taka. Yeah, something less than that. Like 20-something. 20-something.
I don't know who just said. Someone said, what's up with the shoes?
Who, Kabakis? Are you talking about yours?
No, these were Cole's.
Yeah, it was low. Low and outside. It hit?
I thought so, yeah.
I thought it hit. I couldn't tell. I don't know.
I couldn't tell from it. Like, it hit.
Yeah, I thought it was a strike.
I thought it would.
We'll call it
some controversy.
Strike. All right.
Is that three?
Yeah, it's three. So quick. After a great discussion with everyone behind here, questionable. We do.
Most anticlimactic strikeout.
So that's a strikeout there. We're going to go to the third inning. Still no score. And for all your Griffleball needs, follow at Griffleball and at TWalkGBL on Twitter. There's never enough Griffle. And you're Wiffle. Ready to go here in the third inning.
I'm on that good cushion at the house.
Leading off of GasHouse Gorillas, fielder number 43, Ryan Gallagher.
Over one, ground out. Mikey on the bounce so far. Four up, four down. First pitch to Gallagher. Hits it to the left side. We'll get through. No, Kruchek makes a great play out there, one-handed.
Oh,
ranges to his right. Great play to save a hit. So, one pitch, one out. Here's Radishek. And it seems like Radishek's song keep changing. Weeks of like bad at bat, bad at bat.
Extra hitter number 7, Joe Mauer.
Joe Mauer. From the GasHouse Gorillas.
Not
glad
the one
we got
from the Twins, though.
It could be the one from the Twins. We can't really tell, though. First pitch inside.
He's
ball one.
Like
1-0 the count.
You didn't know Joe Mauer is a White Sox fan, hence the hat.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Nice start off with like a 30 overall. You have to
nice pitch from Mikey.
Yeah, Cubs right now versus Sox.
2-0. Sox versus Cubs right now. What do you know?
And if it's like real life, Kubaki might strike him up.
Oh, could be. Nice pitch. Swings through it. There's a good start right there. 2-1.
He's a lefty on the White Sox. yeah, it was like Melky Cabrera versus Jake Arrieta.
Nice pitch.
Oh,
changes pace on pulls the string 2-2.
It's embarrassing.
Rashak not happy with that. As the peanut gallery said, it was embarrassing. Might have
come in about 50 miles per hour, if that.
Next pitch. And strike three. Another 1-2 inning for Mike Kubacki. No hits allowed, one strikeout. We're going to go to the bottom of the third. And for more in-depth analysis, go to our blog at griffleball.blogspot.com. There's never enough griffle in your wiffle. Here in the bottom of the third, we have Mike Kubacki Jr.
Lean off the Ninjas, pitcher number 10, Mike Kubacki.
So far in today's game. No, that's all right. 0-2.
I was going to say, I see Griffleball allows jewelry because he has some earrings, it looks like, of some. I've never noticed that.
At all?
No, never. I've known him for about a couple months now. I've never noticed that.
Good job. First pitch swings. Chop it right back to Tuck, just like his last at bat. So quick, one pitch, one out again here in the bottom of the third.
At least he's consistent.
Field number 13, Sammy Kruchek.
Up next here is Sammy Kruchek. Kruchek looking for the Ninja's first hit and the game's first hit. First pitch, swinging, missing, strike one. 0-1 the count. Here on the bottom of the third, very chilly day.
Nice.
0-2. Oh, good point. Evening.
Yeah, that one might have been 99. That's not official.
0-2 the count. So we're gonna.
Yikes.
I think we're gonna see more extra innings if possible. If this is the case.
Mom
fouls it off. Stays alive. 0-2 the count.
That was
Radishek, the commissioner, could talk to the fans on Periscope if he wants, but he's just staring at the screen.
In the pitch.
My pitch. Fouls it off, stays alive.
He's battling.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
They can't tell him.
Is that your Tinder profile?
Yeah. That's my bio.
Just likes stays alive. He did not go. 1-2. Held up.
We checked the whole umpire out right for that one.
Yeah, he said no. He did not go.
He would be right.
Next pitch. Strikes him out anyway, so a quick 1-2 inning. In the bottom of the third, as well as the top of the third. So we're going to go to the fourth, still no score. And to check out our weekly Power Rankings podcast and statistics, Google League Lineup Griffball and click on the first link. Back here for the top of the fourth, leading off to the GasHouse Gorillas, we have Jim Tucker. So far.
Leading off to the GasHouse Gorillas, number 34, pitcher, Jim Tucker.
So, 0-4. Oh, Mike in the mound.
Which means both guys have no hitters.
That's a true statement. First pitch, just low. 1-0. 1-0 the count. Sammy out there in left, looking ready, hands in pockets, trying to stay warm.
I can't even text right now.
That's how cold it is. 2-0.
That's how I was cold.
Imagine trying to work all the equipment. It is not going very well.
We need to buy a heated dome.
We could. First pitch. Tuck hits it to the right, and that's going to be the first hit of the game here in the top of the fourth. So a leadoff single, and that's going to knock Mikey out of the game. And entering for him is going to be Sammy Kruchek. So we'll be back in just a moment. We have a pitching change.
The camera missed that.
13, Jonathan Herrera.
Back here in the top of the fourth. After a single from Tuck, knocks Mikey out of the game. We got Sammy Kruchek on the mound. Last year, Kruchek 1-3 and 34.5 innings pitched. ERA 5.51, his worst season on the mound. 25 strikeouts, 25 walks.
Still plenty of time to turn that around, though. It's early in the
season. Yeah, it's his first appearance so far.
Right.
So, first pitch, 1-0.
Can only go down from there. At least you would hope.
Next pitch. There's a strike, 1-1.
From Sammy?
Yeah. Last year,
ERA?
Yeah, last year, 5.51 ERA, and had trouble with location last year. A lot of walks, same number of walks as K's, pretty much. Oh, tries to lob one over, almost got him. 2-1 to count. Two and one. Comes the next pitch from Kruchek. Gets him on the high cheese. 2-2.
Is it?
Nice pitch, ready. In the windup. For the stretch. Next pitch. Tries again with an offbeat pitch. Doesn't bite. 3-2 the count. Still very cold here.
That will not change.
We have a very brave man at the plate wearing shorts and a t-shirt.
It's only going to get colder.
Yeah. Definitely. So as the lights are finally coming on. 3-2. There's strike number 3-4. The first out. Oh, my apologies. I wasn't looking up. I was actually watching the game.
No, so I had to plug your social media.
Oh, why, thank you. I appreciate it.
Come on, Nick. Number 43, Ryan Keller.
I got some. Follow me at tweetsby_Kyle.
And don't follow that.
Yeah, she's kind
of hard. Expert analysis on that.
Strike one. One out, one on here.
In the bottom left. one area.
Corner? Bottom left
yeah,
corner?
Yeah, that's where we would call
corner?
That.
Corner? Yeah.
She's not hot.
Number 43.
So, 0-1 the count now.
Yeah.
Next pitch from Krucek. Another fastball, 0-2. So, Krucek quickly on top here.
He's definitely not messing around. He's attacking the strike zone early.
Last year struggled with locations. This could be a different year.
Brand new year.
So, would you use your marker pen for this?
Next pitch from Krucek. Fouls it off. Gallagher staying alive.
Did you use a marker pen for this?
I don't know.
Oh, I mean so.
Oh. Yeah.
I mean, just hitting stance because he doesn't look too good right now.
Count now. Count 0-2. Next pitch from Krucek. Tries to get him to chase. Gallagher didn't bite.
The wind blowing to the left.
I'm too cold to be functioning.
Everyone is too cold to be functioning. I don't know how the players are playing. Especially with a slow game like this where no one's scoring anything, no one's running around. This is not good. People are going to be stiff. And it gets in a strikeout for the second out of the inning. So after the single to lead off the inning, Krucek comes in and gets two strikeouts. So we're going to go to the bottom of the fourth. No score. Leading off for the nighttime ninjas, we have Michael Bakke Jr., number 10 here. Looking for his first hit. Made some contact here.
Leading off the ninjas, Philly, number 10, Mike Kubaki.
Like that.
Keith has those shoes there. Those are an interesting choice.
Well, his team's been wearing them a lot. Well, first pitch, strike one. Oh, on the count.
Nothing on him matches whatsoever.
It's usually the case with the nighttime ninjas.
Oh, the shorts and
the bold move, God. Let's see if it pays off for him.
I don't think it will. One and one.
Get in there. Oh.
Oh, that would have been interesting. One and one the count
crowd
now.
Here today.
I wouldn't call it capacity.
I got a good amount.
Two.
We definitely had less than this before.
We had less than this before. Yeah, the most we've ever had it was what, 20?
It was something on the hockey cage.
Yeah, 20-something.
lowest attendance games of the year always the World Series game.
Stays back. 3-1 the count.
No, everyone's always
nobody played before, so nobody's sticking around.
Yeah.
Like 3-1.
And everyone's just not playing it.
Leading off the inning. There's a fastball, 3-2. I mean, even if I'm swinging. Trying to get back ahead of the count.
That pitch was right there.
Yeah, it was.
He knows where it's at now.
So chances are he'll probably give him an off-speed pitch here.
Yes, I would sing in the same thing.
And there it is, 4-2.
Those off-speeds that start in the middle of the plate and break off at the end are the toughest to hit, I'll tell you that right now.
How would you know?
I did play a little baseball back in the day. And Griffleball.
And that hits the top of the strike zone for strike number 3. Literally.
Pitcher number 13. Same
good swing. Pull the triggers. It looks like a ball coming in. Barely gets back in for strike 3.
Not amused with that one.
Not at all. You saw his face on the Periscope, Cammy. What's that happening? Oh, next here's Sammy Krucek here in the bottom of the fourth. One out. Nobody on. First pitch. Strike 1.
Danger zone from the red.
0-1 count. Next pitch. 1-1, a little bit high. So, what do the ninjas need to do?
They need to out hit the other team to win the ball game.
Very bold prediction. 1-2.
No, if I'm being serious, you got to try to work the count here.
That's tough to do when they try. That's exactly what this guy did back here.
That's exactly what Mike was trying to do, but it's tough when you got the Cy Young out there.
2-2. Yeah, let me call it Cy Young. Color commentator. Didn't bring his research.
My research is my
3-2.
Brain.
3-2. I hope not. Because it'd be everywhere.
Hey, you're absolutely right, Boom.
I
told him, I was like, this is the last time
I'll ever. 3-2 the count.
I'm just waiting for a home run call.
Next pitch. High heat, and he's right out of the inning. Two up, two down. We're going to go to the fifth. Still no score. And this Sunday Night Griffleball broadcast is brought to you by Ballistic. Right. Download their interactive sports app or check out their website, ballisticsports.com. Go Ballistic or go home. Ready to go here in the top of the fifth, leading off.
Leading off for GasHouse Gorillas. Extra hitter, number 47. Jeremy, right here.
He's only got one home run so far this year.
Looks eerily familiar to Joe Mauer.
Could be. First pitch, strike one. Got him chasing a little bit. Not a pitch you want to try to hit. 0-1 the count. Mikey playing in right center. Probably should play more pool knowing Radishak. Next pitch. Gets him out in front of it. 0-2 the count.
Yeah, when I'm playing defense against Radishak, I'm literally almost on the fence.
You might as well. 0-2 the count. Next pitch. Strikes him out, so three pitches. And we got a strikeout. Woo! Up next, we got Jim Tucker. Tucker's ready.
You can't be more efficient.
No, you can't. Well,
picture number 34, Jim Tucker.
It's right back to him. Yeah, but I'm sure he's much rather strike out. Yeah. Wow, so three batters so far for Krucek. All three strikeouts. And up next here is Jim Tucker. A guy who doesn't strike out often at all. First pitch, ball one. 1-0 the count.
Got one.
Count. 1-0. You're in the top of the fifth inning. No score between the Ninjas and Gorillas. Nice pitch, 2-0.
Top five, Tyler. This is technically the last inning.
Yes, it is. In Griffleball, we play five.
They do. But the way things have been going today, we might be going more than five.
Yeah, we might be here all night for just one game. Nice pitch. Oh, no, Tucker gets a hold of it, but Mikey's right under it for the second out. So we're going to go to the bottom of the fifth. Still no score. We're on the bottom of the fifth, leading off the Nighttime Ninjas, manager Mike Kubaki.
Leading off the Nighttime Ninjas, fielder number 10.
Looking for their first Kubaki. Hit. If battled all the way through, they can either win the game here or we go to extras. First pitch from Tuck. Ball one. So, as you said earlier, you got to work the count here. Got to get a hit. Get him out of the game if you get a hit. It's possible.
That's when you might have your best chance of scoring.
Oh, there, that could have been it right there. Straddles the line, but that's a strike.
Mikey seems very frustrated. He thinks he just missed that one.
So count 1-1. Next pitch from Tucker. Good eye there, 2-1.
Should be right.
Yeah.
It's a pull.
Yeah.
Obviously, Gallagher playing out right center. So everyone's usually late on these fastballs from Tucker. Next pitch. There's a strike.
Oh, that little thing that comes out.
Yeah. Once again, acknowledging right down the middle.
Mm-hmm. The 2-2. That's a little bit outside.
Lister did a poor job. Just a little bit. White on the
not right down the middle.
We haven't decided to change it yet.
Next pitch.
We got some
stays alive. Count remains even at 2.
You can probably notice that every fielder that is out there has got their hands in their pockets right until the last one.
Probably a good strategy. Exactly. Fouls it off again.
Good battle here by Kubaki.
Doing the hell. He just needs to find a way to get a base runner or just get a hit somehow. Poke one. Swings at it, misses. Chases one low. That's another strikeout for Tucker. That is his 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th strikeout.
Pitcher number 13, Sammy Kruchek.
Ninjas still searching for their first hit, but they're still in this game. And a chance to win with one swing of the bat. And that could be it! Kruchek hits it deep and it's gone!
Mamma mia!
Nighttime Ninjas went on a walk-off from Sammy Kruchek. 1-0 here in the first game. We'll be back for game number 2 for the second part of Sunday Night Griffleball. Game 2 of Sunday Night Griffleball. In case you missed it, Nighttime Ninjas went on a walk-off 1-0 via Sammy Kruchek home run off of Jim Tucker. You won't see that much.
Especially today.
Not at all. I'll lead it off for GasHouse Gorillas in game 2. Here's Ryan Gallagher. Fun stat. All of Jim's losses in the nighttime. All of his career losses in the regular season. Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. That's all right. Make yourself at home. Tell me where you've been. That's on top of my head.
Lead off for GasHouse Gorillas. Fisher number 43. Ryan Gallagher.
Last game of the night, Tyler.
That last game? We're ready to go.
T-Walk GBL on Twitter.
There we go. Plugging me again. Or tweets by Kyle. Or tweets by underscore.
Tweets by underscore Kyle.
Well, we're almost ready to go. Looks like there's something wrong with the fence out there. I think Mikey's ready. He's walking back to the mound. Leisurely pace.
Started game 1. He's also going to start game 2 here.
Got no decision in game 1.
One hit.
One hit. Hasn't run a lot of run all year, so see if he continues that trend. It'll be a good sign for the Ninjas. First pitch. Ball 1. 1-0 to go. In case you didn't know, Strike Zone sponsored by Blitzstick. Go Blitzstick, go home. Next pitch. Gets on top of it. Kruchek's in the best spot possible and almost ate him up, but yeah. It's going to be a ground out.
You got a lot of speed coming off the bat. That'd be tough to feel.
That's a
Fielder number 47, Jeremy Rajan.
Pitch. Strike one to Radishek.
Well, I mean, if you only won, lost by one run, though. So.
Yeah, I think they lost 2-0, 1-0.
Gotta blame the offense.
0-1 on the count here to Radishek. Pops it up. Can anybody get there? And that's a no. That's a foul ball. 0-2. No effort out there from the mound. Usually see some
minimal effort there by Kubaki.
Just kind of let that one go. 0-2 the count. So quickly on top. Next pitch. A little bit low. 1-2.
Someone did die on that. Over there. Lucky.
Was there any blood?
Oh, possibly. Probably. Gets on top of it as well. Lets it roll by him, and Kruchek gets it for the second out. So, 2-2 two down. We're going to go to the bottom of the first, no score. And for more in-depth analysis, go to our blog at griffleball.blogspot.com.
Sandwich.
All ready to go here in the bottom of the first. On the mound for the GasHouse Gorillas, we have Ryan Gallagher. So far this season, 0-0. 3-inning pitch.
but nothing else has been recorded because the game hasn't been finished yet, but it's going to get a no decision no matter what. It hasn't given up a run, so we know that. But that game will be completed the next time they play the Ducks on the pond, so we'll see what happens there. This could be his first complete game.
It's going to look out. Very creative.
Yeah, I like it. GasHouse Gorillas, Nighttime Ninja. That's leading off for the Nighttime Ninja. Sammy Krucek. Looks like he's almost ready to go. I'm looking for him.
Got a fan that's actually got his girl watching Justin Timberlake.
Oh, nice. Well, they were almost ready. A small ball break. So a little premature here. I'm getting started. So we'll kind of fill time here. It is, yeah, a little bit cold.
It's probably 40.
It might be less. Can we get a weather report here, Matt Zarowski? How cold is it?
We are in Highland.
What does it feel like? I want to know what the degrees is. I want to know what it feels like.
It feels like it's 30. Yeah, the real feel might be in the 30s. Or at least it does.
We got our weather guy checking it out right now.
I got a nice winter
still. 44 degrees feels like 40.
Feels like 40. Does not feel like 40, feels like 30.
Yeah.
I thought I'd point that out there. The wind.
Yeah, there is a slight wind, I would say, about 10 miles per hour.
Yeah, we're ready. So we're ready to go after this small delay.
Leading off for the Nighttime Ninjas. Field goal number 13. Sammy Krucek.
Last at bat, in case you didn't see it, won the game. So first pitch from Gallagher. Strike one. A little bit of high cheese. 0-1 the count.
High cheddar, you don't want it.
Brad check out in left center. Looks like, I don't know what he's doing. I hope we get that on camera. I don't know what was going on. Next
barely
pitch. Strike two, 0-2. Trying to stay warm out there. I don't know what he's doing.
You know, you just got to find ways to stay warm out there, Tyler. You know, whether it's shaking your hands, rubbing them together, or just keeping them in your pocket.
Next pitch, a little bit low. And outside, 1-2 the count. Here in the second game, we got no score.
We have the family divide in there.
Ninjas took the first game. Next pitch, 2-2. Trying to get him to chase here. Two waste pitches, kind of. Krucek's still in the count.
Hands between the thighs is what a fan said.
No, that might be a good idea.
Instead of keeping the hands warm.
A little bit inside. Good take. That could have hit the top of the corner of the strike zone, but it's going to be 3-2. 3-2 a count.
3-2 is not a full count here in Griffleball. 5-2.
4-2.
4-2, correct.
Gets him on low fastball for out number one. So Gallagher tallies a strikeout. Up next here is Mike Kubacki. And they throw it around out there.
Pitcher number 10, Mike Kubacki.
Now, would you call that around the horn, or what would you call that?
I would call that back and forth.
I would have to agree. That's actually great. You're absolutely right, Boom.
First pitch, low, but hits the board. Strike one.
Anything that hits the board is a strike.
0-1 the count. Next pitch from Gallagher. Bringing the heat. 1-1. That was definitely low. Four ball. 1-1 the count here in game two. Bottom of the first, one out here.
Ooh, almost got him in the face.
2-1. And then it would be very.
Yeah, today that wouldn't be.
Yeah, that would not. That would hurt. Probably leave a mark.
You'd get a mark.
Have holes on your face. That's not fun.
That would be interesting.
Next pitch. Fouls it off, right back at us.
Mikey walks home to the girlfriend with holes on his face.
I don't know how that conversation would go. Where'd you get those?
Oh, it took a ball to the face.
Never a thing you want to say to anybody. Next pitch. Strike three, so two up, two down as Gallagher strikes out the side. We're going to go to the second, no score. And this year's Home Run Derby in 2017 GBL All-Star Game will be sponsored by and played on location at Bridges Scoreboard. Ready to go here in the top of the second, leading off for the GasHouse Gorillas. We have Jim Tucker.
Leading off for the GasHouse Gorillas, extra hitter, number 34, Jim Tucker.
It will be live Periscope, of course.
Yeah,
it will
be on Periscope.
Get up! Wing hits it deep, but not deep enough. As he takes the first pitch for a ride, but Krucek's all over it for the first out.
There was a warning track, I would say that.
That's your hitter, number 13.
I would say it's about
John
a warning track.
Reyna.
Up next here is John Reyna. There's Reyna, one out already. One out, one pitch. A couple times Kobaki's done that.
Ooh, got him to chase him.
First pitch swinging, and his Stallionaire's motto from last year is see it high, let it fly. And he wanted to.
I was talking about
it. Is that actually his
mom? Yeah, I think that was the team motto. Oh, almost tried to sneak one in there. 1-1 the count.
Fan said warning track power.
1-1. Number 13, looking for his first hit in the 2017 campaign. Doesn't like that ball. That ball's gone.
Right,
and he likes this one. You'll see that a lot from a couple of pitchers. All right, next pitch from Kubacki. Outside. 2-1 the count. So, Reyna didn't swing the first pitch. He could be sitting in a nice spot here with 3-0. It's 2-1. Next pitch.
Ooh, try to get him the high one again. Four and one the count.
Right there. He wanted that.
I wanted that.
That was in his hot zone.
Four and one the count. Four and one.
No, there's no bunting here. I'm just assuming.
No bunting.
Yeah.
Why not? Try to fight back into the count.
And he has a walk, so guy on first base now for Ryan Gallagher.
Exactly what the Grills needed right there, Tyler.
They definitely didn't need base runners. They had only
pitcher number 43, Ryan Gallagher.
They had one base runner, and that was a one single last game.
Fans want them to go to the bullpen here. I don't know if it's time for that.
I know. He hasn't given up a run all year. I don't know if that's the case.
Sabaki with a zero ERA first pitch.
Right. Gallagher not happy with that. Took it right down the middle. Only one the count. Visibly frustrated. 43.
And could you blame
him? Here's the next one. Oh, and gets him chasing that one. 0-2. He's got them all messed up on the plate right now. He doesn't even know what's coming next. I don't even know what's coming next.
Just call that a curveball by Kibaki.
Change up.
Change up. Okay.
Next pitch. Tries to. He just misses. 1-2. Hits the phone down there on the bottom.
Which is not a strike.
Not a strike. So 1-2 the count here. One on, one out here in the top of the second. Fouls it off. Count remains the same.
Spinner.
A little bit of spinner. Most people a couple years ago would actually let that ball spin and see if it came back and play.
Oh, yeah.
But that rule's now out.
What you gotta do.
Gets him on the changeup for out number two. We're gonna go to the bottom of the second. No score. And for all your Griffleball needs, follow at Griffleball or at TWOGGBL on Twitter. Ready to go here in the bottom of the second. Leading off for the ninth time. It's first Sammy Kuchel.
We opened it in
Gallagher
off for a team. Sammy Kuchel.
Struck out the first two batters in the first pitch to Kuchel. Swing and a miss. Strike one. 0-1 the count here in the bottom of the second. Ninja's looking for the sweep. I'd call that the shock of the evening. I predict a split. A pitch. Lost his changeup there. 1-1 the count.
For those watching for the first time, GasHouse Gorillas, 5-time Griffleball champion.
Oh, did not know that. Or they can check out our website.
We have a lot of new lists.
That's a good point. 5-time champions?
Who's this?
Yep. Huh? They can also find them at Griffleball.
Is that yours, Logan?
Next pitch. 2-1 the count. 2-2.
Just a bit. It's so cold I can't even think right now.
Oh, that's usually the case. Well, 2-2 the count.
Yeah.
Yeah, it usually is.
Is that a study?
I think it might be 3-2. Obviously, you freeze yourself. That's all you're thinking about.
Can the fans on Periscope clarify?
Yeah, can we clarify that if it's cold out? Do you lose your brain?
Thought process? Do you lose your brain?
Yeah, that's all I want to say.
That's usually the case.
Next pitch. High cheese misses. 4-2 to count.
That is a full count.
We have a full count here to Kruchek. Siding pitch. Kruchek hits it deep to right center. It doesn't have enough. No, but it's going to land in for a... I can't see from here. It was blocking my view. It's either a double or a triple. I think it looked like a double.
Straight ahead. Why would you look straight ahead?
I see where it landed.
Can we get an official rule?
Brad, scoot over in just a second. We'll take just a moment to clarify if that was a double or triple. So, as recorded, GasHouse went out to the field. It landed in the triple area. Double. I don't say category. That doesn't make any sense. I didn't know we were playing Jeopardy
double.
Today.
What classifies a double? Oh, it sounds like you said double.
Triple. In Griffle Grounds, triples in the corners, and anything else past the single line.
Pitcher number 10, Mike.
There's a nice little line out. We're about where Radishek's standing, about a foot behind him. That'll be a single. Okay. I couldn't
so
tell
he
from
got
there.
It in that 4 foot.
Yeah, so, guy on third base to lead off the bottom of the second.
Fans wanted us to go to New York on that.
Kibaki holds up. 1-0 the count. We can go to New York. We'll go to Indianapolis here. We're in Indiana.
Okay. Yeah.
Or Chicago. That's a little closer.
That's a good point. 1-0 the count. Kibaki with a chance to drive and run. Ooh, good pitch that hit. Just misses it 1-1.
Yeah, beep at the Nighttime Ninjas, New Jersey. So.
And purple camo. Gotta like it. Bring their A game.
Seems to be the new guy.
1-2.
I do like that a lot, too.
You see a lot of people nowadays going with that look. I like that. That's nice.
If you didn't hear the podcast, I had a jersey ranking. That was number 2. Next pitch. Outside, 2-2.
Who's
the
one?
Huh?
One?
Ducks on the pot.
You like them?
No, I love them.
What do they rock?
I got some like old school retro jerseys. Kind of look like they're from the
70s. Blue, the second game.
Fouls it off. Kind of an excuse me swing. But fouls it off really deep.
Yeah.
2-2.
Kibaki's been making a lot of long counts, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. Working the counts, 2-2.
Oh, they wanted to check the swing in the last one.
2-2 count.
A little win.
Next pitch.
Pop,
fouls
bro.
It off. Count remains even at 2. So Mikey battling, making the GasHouse pitchers throw a lot of pitches here on the
mound. He might be leading the night.
He could. Ooh, there's trying to slow him up. 2-2. And we're going to do it again. Kyle remains exactly even at 2.
I think that is his fourth foul ball here. Yeah, this at bat
fourth,
itself.
Fifth. You never know.
Keeping tally at home, let us know.
Oh, good eye there. 3-2. Well, definitely working the count. Guy on third base. Single brings him in. So hit a grounder anywhere where Radishek's not in right. Got yourself a run. There's strike number 3.
I don't think Kibaki was expecting that.
Good battle, though, from Kibaki. Made him throw a lot of pitches. Up next here is Sammy Krucek as he's grabbing a couple of balls for the pitcher. He's throwing in the net and he's ready to go.
Okay. Fielder number 13, Sammy Krucek.
First pitch from Gallagher. Hits him. So 1-0-1 the count.
Charge.
Think about that, Tyler. He got the win on the mound and he got the win at the plate.
That's not good.
Jesus Christ.
It's a deep, but it's going to go foul. Can Gallagher get there? No, he may chase.
He's going ACL.
So count.
Where the piece snap from here?
It was in the grass.
1-1 the count here at the bottom of the second.
Oh, wow.
Ninja's threatening with a guy on third base.
I thought it was all.
Let's see if Krucek can bring himself in. So 1-1-1 the count. If he gets hit again by a pitch, next batter. 1-1-1. Next pitch from Gallagher. Hits the bottom. 1-2-1.
Barely.
It's a tough pitch.
Like Bobo last week, painting the corners out here.
Painting corners to see if Krucek can get this guy from third in. Fouls it off.
The guy with the green shoes is the other team member of the Nighttime Ninjas.
1-2-1 the count here. Next pitch from Gallagher. Gets him a strikeout. So as Sammy leads off with a triple, then Gallagher falls with two straight strikeouts. We're going to go to the third. Still no score. Ready to go here in the top of the third, leading off for the GasHouse Gorillas. Here's Jerry Radishek. Probably the guy with the most top in their bat in this lineup.
Leading off for the GasHouse Gorillas, number 47, Jeremy Radishek.
Looking to get his team on the board first here in game number 2. First pitch from Kibaki. Oh, got him to pull a string again. Strike 1. Oh, Radishek not ready for that changeup here. Can't wait back.
Seems to be confusing the batters today. Mixing up speeds.
Changing his speeds.
Different locations. Sometimes that's all you need.
Could have been playing a lot of the show lately.
Yeah.
1-1. Not a very good game.
Freeze. Speaking of freezing.
Yeah, the weather. Let me know. 1-1 the count.
You know about the weather? You know about the GasHouse Gorillas being 5-time champs?
I think you've said that at least more than 5 times.
Yeah, 5 times.
All right, 1-1. Next pitch from Kibaki. Gets out in front of it. See, as he's not ready for the off-speed pitch again, it's getting out 1-2.
Probably the best contact we've seen from the Grills today, though. Square that up. Just.
Dude, I'm getting invited. Next pitch. Hits him. 2-2-1. Definitely hit your foot, right, Rat?
Yeah.
Okay. 2-2-1 the count. Nobody out here. Gets him out in front of it again.
It's like a knuckleball or something like that, Tyler.
Yeah, it's definitely, definitely throwing off Radishek here at the plate. Let's see if he comes back with it again, or he's just going to try to throw a fastball.
I see a leggings around.
That's where things start getting tricky as a batter. You don't know what's going on. Oh, tried the fastball. Missed. 3-2.
Yeah, I think that would have been a little high for you to show.
3-2-1. Krucek out and right. Waiting for the pitch. Getting ready. Here it comes. Ooh, just missed the outside top corner of the strike zone. We got a Griff full count here. 4-2-1. This will be the deciding pitch.
Kibaki definitely wanted that pitch right there.
As Radishek is the leadoff batter. You can see it. You got to hit his zone, see what he does here. Ooh. Oh, gets in the whiff at another changeup. Radishek's not ready for that, so that is the first out there. And up next for the GasHouse Gorillas, we got Jim Tucker, who is staying warm, took off his jacket, and rushes to the plate. He's ready to go. Oh, he's literally ready to go. All right, 34. Looking for the first hit for GasHouse. Gave it to him last time. And there, it could be again. Can Krucek get there? No. And Tuck gets the first hit for the GasHouse Gorilla here in the top of the third. So a guy on first base, one out for John Reyna. I think Tuck just wanted to get out of there, get back into his jacket. I think that might be the case.
Actually, number 13, John.
So a guy on first base, one out here in the top of the third. First pitch. Not sure what kind of swing that was, but strike one. The only one to count. All right, one. Next pitch. Fouls it off. 0-2. So Reyna quickly behind in the count here. A couple of odd swings. 0-2. Comes the next pitch from Kibaki. Kind of moves his foot out of the way. Must have been scared of it. 1-2-1. Kuchek out in left center. One on, one out here in the top of the third. 1-2-1. Next pitch. Hit. The hit is bad.
Yes, it was.
So the count's going to remain the same.
You got the knob.
This has to be the most
right
interesting
there
at bat of the night so far.
Yeah.
1-2-1 the count. Next pitch. Fastball, strike three. And after Tuck gets the first hit of the game, Kibaki strikes out both Radishak and Reyna. And we're going to the bottom of the third. No score still. And this Sunday Night Griffleball broadcast is brought to you by Ballistic. Download their interactive sports app or check out their website, ballisticsports.com. Go Ballistic or go home. Bottom of the third inning, still no score. Leading off for the Nighttime Ninjas, Mike Kibaki. 1-0, looking for...
Leading off for the Ninjas. Pitch number 10, Mike Kibaki.
In the series today. First pitch. Oh, almost broke his ankles. We are playing on a basketball court, right, so I guess it does make sense.
Break his ankles.
0-1 the count. Didn't know that
was possible.
The green
shoes, the fans were wondering about the green shoes.
Next pitch. Oh, way out in front of that 0-2. His head is in the skies in left field. I don't know what's up there.
There's
nothing. The sky's
no stars,
up there.
No
stars. No, nothing. No flyovers tonight either. No. You're upset about that. 0-2 the count. Next pitch from Gallagher. I don't.
That was not a foul ball. I'm pretty sure.
That's, that is not a foul ball. Yes. Strike three. Not the greatest of swings. So that was Gallagher's fifth strikeout.
Ball, the worst of the bat of all time.
Fielder number 13. Sammy
I don't know
Kruchek.
What just happened there.
Well, up next, here's
quality entertainment.
Here's Sammy Kruchek. First pitch, ball one.
Okay.
So 1-0 the count.
Where is that? Yonka?
Yeah, 1-0. Next pitch to Kruchek from Gallagher. Ooh, good pitch there. 1-1 the count. Next pitch. 2-1 the count. Liking what I'm seeing from Gallagher on the mound earlier on the year. Didn't see that last year. Had a year, right? Somewhere in the fours or fives, if I'm not mistaken, off the top of my head. But I like the heat he's bringing this year. And then so far, right now we're at 3-1 the count. So 3-1 the count. Nobody on. One out. It's in deep to right. Will that be enough?
No.
No. Foul ball. It just slices
just
at the
foot right there.
Last
Tyler.
Second.
Yeah.
I thought that was going.
That's where the win came into play once again. Any other night, that might be
so,
fair.
We'll do it again. So three. Two strikes here on Kruchek. That was almost dangerous. Oh, and we got a small ball break. We'll be back in just a moment. And our ball break is brought to you by, for all your Griffball needs, follow at Griffball or at TWalkGBL on Twitter. Also, check out our Facebook page for live videos, photos, and other news. Just search Griffball and give us a thumbs up. And we're back from the ball break. Now it counts 4-2. 4-2 the count here. One out. Nobody out here in the bottom of the third. Definitely getting way too cold, I think. Not feeling it. It's a top of one foul ball. So we got a 4-2. We're going to do it again. We'll check all over this. We'll see if gets him to chase. Next pitch. Hits it right up the middle. And that's going to be a single there for Sammy Kruchek. So a guy on first base. And Mike Kibaki's got a runner.
Sammy having himself a day at the plate.
This is the case for Sammy Kruchek. You've seen his stats last year.
Pitcher number 10, Mike Kibaki.
Fans like to know who's favorite probably in this game. You'd say GasHouse.
I would have said GasHouse, but Ninjas are looking for the sweep now after winning that first game.
If you did not see the first game, the Nighttime Ninjas, who are at the bat right now, won 1-0 on Sammy's walk-off home run in the right field.
1-0 the count. Next pitch from Gallagher. High cheese, 2-0.
He did not go.
2-0, man on first, one out here on the bottom of the third. Ninja's looking to break through first. Takes a little bit off of that one, and Rat's out there in a perfect spot for the second out. So we're going to go into the fourth inning. Still no score. And for more in-depth analysis, go to our blog at griffleball.blogspot.com. There's never enough griffle in your wiffle. Ready to go here in the top four. Still no score. In case you missed, there's only been one run in this series so far, so something's got to change. First pitch from Sammy. 1-0 count, ball outside. In the top of the fourth here. Team's looking to break through in this cold night. You gotta wonder if the weather's definitely affecting the hitters.
Oh, absolutely.
2-0.
2-0 count, okay.
Viewers on Periscope, gotta like it. 17 viewers, thanks for watching. There's a strike, 2-1 the count. 2-1 right now.
Now.
Top of the fourth. Taking his time getting back to the mound. As you see in center field, I don't think you can see it on the YouTube broadcast, but the Periscope broadcast.
It, yeah, top left.
GasHouse Gorilla logo. 3-1 now. That was decided by Commissioner Jeremy Radishak that every Sunday night Griffleball match and series, essentially, they're going to see the logo rising above everyone else. Pretty much the case.
It's a motivation right there.
It is motivation. There's a strike. Count 4-2. 4-2 the count. We're at full here.
Now, if you were to hit the logo on the basketball...
Oh, it's 3-2. 3-2. What's up?
It would be a home run, right?
Yeah, if you hit the backboard, it is a home run. Any part of it, the rim or the net.
The net, too?
Yeah. I believe if you hit the net, is a home run. Am I correct? Yeah. Any part of the backboard, including the net and rim, is a home run.
Very interesting.
Still haven't seen one go in yet. Fouls it off.
Someone had one in Lister, like...
Years ago, though.
Oh.
I think I was here broadcasting games.
Really?
Yeah, 4-2 right now.
That would be Lister thing, right? Oh, yeah.
First batter here at the top of the fourth.
Yeah.
Same Sammy. Just fouls it off. We're going to do it again here. Repeat. 4-2. Gallagher walks around. Trying to get his thoughts in place. See what's coming next from Krucek. See what 43 can do. Here's the pitch. Gets in a strikeout on a low pitch. So got him chasing there. Could have been ball number 5. And things are just flying everywhere. I don't know what just happened.
You got a wiffle balls going there.
And up next here is Jeremy Radishak.
Fielder number 47, Jeremy Radishak.
All right, here's Rat. Guys need to get something going here. Still scoreless. It's been a while since they scored a run. In case you were wondering, like the Ducks on the Pond and the GasHouse Gorillas, it's really cold. I'm starting to feel it now. The very first inning of Sunday Night Griffleball is the only runs GasHouse Gorillas have scored all year.
Yeah, today they have gone 9 innings without
that is a run. That is a true statement because they haven't scored in the Ducks on the Pond makeup game yet. So they have been, so let's say 4, that's 4, it's 8, got 5, 13.
5 balls is a walk for those.
16 innings without a run for the GasHouse Gorillas, and I don't think that's going to help. That could help as it... eats up Kabaki out there. That is
an error by
Kabaki. An E. E2 there.
The ball. That is an error. And the guy gets on first base.
Because one out here, one on.
Extra hitter, number 34, Jim.
This could be the opportunity for the GasHouse Gorillas to score their first run. Since this. They haven't scored a run in 16 innings of gameplay.
This whole year?
Yeah, they've scored the first inning against the Ducks on the Pond, 4 runs in it. Nothing since. First pitch, strike 1. 0-1 the count. Guy on first base via the error. It actually came back to bite the Nighttime Ninjas a couple weeks ago against the Digger Dudes. They made an error out in the field and they lost that game without giving up a hit to the Digger Dudes.
Yeah,
you don't give up a hit. Pitch. 1-1 the count.
No hit loss. How many times have you seen that?
No, not too often, actually. Might happen once every 2 years here.
Right. Definitely not in baseball.
Not very often. Next pitch. High. 2-1. 2-1 the count here with Tuck. Guy on first base. Triple will score that run, unearned. Next pitch. Doesn't get him the chase. No surprise there. 4-1.
That ball bounced about 4 feet in front of home plate.
3-1, sorry. 3-1 the count. Next pitch from Krucek. 4-1 now.
Let's go! Come on!
Guy on first base. Get this guy on second, only a double will get a chance to score. That's good news. Here comes the pitch. Oh, you're not going to be swinging. That's a walk right there. So guys on first and second.
He makes what?
One out here. And here's John Reyna.
What? 5,200 a month?
Well, he has moving to the left side is Kabaki. Couldn't see it on the YouTube camera.
That's right, number 13, John Reyna.
Double hero gets him in. First pitch high for ball one. Usually likes to swing at that pitch. Kind of surprised he didn't.
Ty let it fly.
1-0 the count.
But yeah, he's only in there for like...
Next pitch from Krucek. There's a strike. 1-1. So, good approach by Reyna. Make him throw a strike first. 1-1 for 13. See if 13 can get something going here. Double brings it in. Ooh, goes around 1-2. He knows it too. One and two the count. 2-1, 1-out. Oh, okay. Oh, he strikes him out for strike 3. So they get out of a little mini jam there. We're going to go to the bottom of the first, fourth. Still no score. Here we are at the bottom of the fourth. Pitcher change for the GasHouse Gorillas. Jeremy Radishak going to step in on the mound. Radishak so far this year. 2 innings pitch, 1 hit allowed, 1 strikeout, 1 walk, and a save.
Looking off for the Nighttime Ninjas. Pitcher number 13, Sammy Krucek.
Sammy Krucek.
Yes, Griffleball on the basketball court.
That's so two hits so far in today's game for Sammy. First pitch. Gets on top of it, and that's going to be an easy out for Gallagher as he just ranges over and grabs it. So one pitch, one out for Radishek. Here's Mike Ibaka. Let's see if he can get anything going for the ninjas, or he could be here a while.
Yeah,
he
might
be
here for
a while. There seems to be barely any offense today as a whole.
I think this we've had three games, finished 1-0.
Yeah.
Or four.
For four. Sure.
Four games.
Finished 1-0.
Next pitch.
Usually you see a little more offense in there, right?
A little bit, but I think the strike zone is definitely playing out a factor this season.
Is this the first year you guys were here?
First year, we used to use that launch here last year.
Okay.
I think
it was way past the strike.
There's a strike 1-1. Make him throw a strike first. We got 1-1 right here. One out here in the bottom of the fourth. Ninja's trying to get the brooms out. Next pitch from Rat. I think he tried his slider there and he missed it.
I was going to say, that definitely was not
your 2-1. Pitch. Yeah, you can definitely tell he's having trouble gripping the ball. Trying to stay 2-1.
It's hard to even text on the phone right now.
Fouls it off, 2-2. I'm glad I'm not on my phone because currently it is being used for Periscope.
Yes.
Hey, by the way, can you retweet the Griffleball Open Rats
phone? T-Walk,
retweet the T-Walk GBL Periscope
on Twitter.
2-2. 3-2 the count now. One out here. 1-0. Looking
once again, Tyler Kubacki working count.
Once again, he seems to do that a lot. Works the count.
From his Griffleball
looking for his first hit in the series today. See if we can get it here. And I think he might have. No, they didn't go far enough, and Gallagher's all over it for the second out. So two ground outs there for Radishek to end the inning. We're going to go to the fifth. Still, no score and no surprise there.
Tyler.
Looks like we're back here in the top of the fifth. Sammy on the mound taking a couple more warm-up pitches. Leading off for the GasHouse Gorillas, we have Ryan Gallagher. Oh, going back to his old school song.
Open up the champagne.
My house, come on,
oh, wow.
Turn it up. Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. Make yourself at my home, tell me where you been.
Feel a little more
they won the championship last year. Their low goal is to stay up for every Sunday night baseball game. First pitch from Sammy to Gallagher. Strike one. Not swinging. So 0-1 the count here. GasHouse looking for some offense, or they could be sitting at 1-2 after the game. Chopper right back to the mound. Krucek all over it for the first out. So two pitches, one out. That's next year's
play, right? Number 47.
Absolutely. Today in alone, ten innings of scoreless
baseball. The only runs they've got were the first inning in the first Sunday Night Griffleball matchup, and that was it. Oh, gets him out in front of it. Changeup's definitely full in Radishek on the mound.
Need to find some offense here.
I think the scouting report's finally out. Throw changeup to Rat.
I'm gonna try and make the call. He's going yards.
Oh, we got a call here. Bogus.
Bold prediction.
Manager of the talk of ever says he's gonna go yards. And 0-2.
Get in there.
That was close to going yard. 0-2 the count.
Little
0-2, one out. Next pitch from Krucek. Gets out in front of it a little bit. Kubaki's all over. Does stay with it. Another error out there in the field.
Second error for Kubaki.
Extend the inning. I think I just rule out the gold hands contention now.
Yeah.
All right, so we got a guy on first base via the error. Up next here's Jim Tucker.
Next is here, number 34.
They had a chance last inning, they didn't capitalize. Now they have a chance here. We got a good batter up here.
Sometimes that's what it takes.
First pitch from Krucek, one out here in the top of the fifth. Trying an off-speed pitch, kind of missed.
Boston Red Sox have
it. Big Boston guy. 1-0 count. Takes a deep breath on the mound, ready for the second pitch of the at-bat. Here it comes. Fastball hits it to the right side. It slowed down a little bit. Kubacki stays with it as a couple of funny bounces. So that's the second out. So the error does not come back to bite the Ninjas. We're going to go to the bottom of the fifth. Ninjas have a chance to win the game once again. Ready to go here in the bottom of the fifth.
You know, the bottom of the fifth for the nighttime Ninjas. Pitcher number 13, Sammy Krucek.
We'll see Krucek in the exact same situation he was in game one. He has a chance to win it with a walk. Will he do it? Oh, hits first pitch swing and single. So gets on base to start. The top of the fifth.
Absolutely destroying the ball today.
Usually what happens with Krucek swings, we've noticed.
Fielder number 10, Mike Kubacki.
Also in a similar situation as Kruchek was in the last two games, has a chance to win the game and see if he can pull it off.
You know, Tyler, when I say he was absolutely destroying the ball, I meant that literally.
Pitch swing is
absolutely destroying the wiffle balls.
Oh, yeah, we've seen that a lot with the new balls we bought this year. Not quality griffle balls.
Not
here.
The greatest griffle balls.
No. 0-1 the count. Man on first base. Next pitch, 1-1.
Looks like Kubacki is standing a little further away from the plate.
I think I know why. If you've seen the guy's slider, which I've
trying
really
to get
seen
around
it.
On it.
Yeah. Next pitch. There it is. There it hits was. Him. 2-1-1. The slider's not breaking.
Yeah, two hit by pitches is a base.
All right, so I can get it L here if it's hits him again. You never know. Next pitch. Fastball. 2-2-1 the count.
Well, some high heat right there.
Tough to get that one.
Yeah. Noticed, yeah, you're definitely gonna take some time to get used to it. Oh, fouls it off.
Got him to chase one that was probably 2 feet above the strike.
Never know, though. That could have been very interesting. Right now, we're in the bottom of the fifth, one on. Nobody out here. Scoreless game in game number two. Ninja's looking for the sweep. See if they can pull it off. Next pitch. They found front. Rare, right back to Rare. Good reaction time. That's it. Tough play. And the guy on here, Sammy, again.
Can't say
pitcher number 13,
Sammy Kucha. He's playing a hard tackle, but he definitely can get around the ball and take it to the left, so you got
to
watch
true,
out.
But he did hit his single this inning to the right side.
And his
home
run
last game.
First pitch, tried him with the slider, just missed. 1-0.
Toes are frozen.
Everything's frozen right
I'm
now.
I'm wearing flip-flops in 38-degree weather.
Yeah, I'm not sure what you were thinking. I told you that earlier. You're going, yeah, I'll be fine. 2-0. Yeah, oh, that ball just came back. That hurt.
Right at the flip-flops.
Yeah, watch out for your feet.
Mama
watch your toes. I break. 2-0 the count. Nice pitch. High heat.
It
hits the top.
Like, Tyler, you are out of data.
Oh, too bad. 2-1. We're gonna still gonna go. I'm out of data. Been out of, that's what Periscope does. We're always out of data. So we're $15 right now. Fouls it off. 2-2.
And T-Walk GBL, the media coordinator, sacrificing his data to
yep.
Periscope the game.
I got paid league fees for a reason, so that's where it goes to. Most of the data paid.
You're absolutely right, though.
Thanks.
Verizon Unlimited.
Doesn't like me. 2-2.
Oh,
Sammy hits it deep. Will that be
damn it.
Home run number 2?
Oh, yes!
Another walk-off. He didn't think he had enough.
Second walk-off of the night
and
in
Sammy
the nighttime ninja.
Sammy Kruchek does it again. Unbelievable.
They take the series by two walk-offs.
So the Ninjas have swept the GasHouse Gorillas via two walk-off home runs from Sammy Kruchek. That puts them at 3-1 on the season. That puts GasHouse at 1-2. So you could flip around the standings. You be sure the power rankings are going to change next week. So thanks for listening, and thanks for watching. Wiffle out.